Okay, let's start off with our today's topic. So what are oscillators? The oscillators are the graphic representation of changes in prices and determine the volatility within a market. For people who have been with technical analysis, there are two kinds of oscillators. One are called the lagging oscillators. Those oscillators take their values from the price chart, like a moving average or say a MACD histogram. Those oscillators take their values from the price charts and give signals a bit later than the price chart. But when we talk about some leading oscillators, which we are going to talk about today, those are those oscillators which give you an idea of a price change before the market gives you the first signal. So it might be that the stock market or that particular price of a stock is moving up, but this leading oscillator is giving you a sell signal before the price chart. So when we talk about the leading oscillators, they are meant to give us a prior signals of trend reversal. As you are here for learning oscillators, I believe. Where is the chat thing?
In the long. Switch off the webcam. Webcam, go to webcam.
Webcam here. This one. Stop it.
Yes.
Which one?
Stop sharing the webcam.
Stop sharing screen. Message. Okay, so
a little loud.
So the oscillators, the leading oscillators, are meant to give you prior signals. Trend is our friend, and oscillators give you the first signs of reversals in the trend. So what are oscillators? The oscillators are the graphic representation of the change in price and determine the volatility within a market. Oscillators experience oscillations that permit to identify the volatility in the market. Now, oscillators can be defined as a price derivative. What are the different three kinds of signals which an oscillator give? There's a overbought, there's a oversold, when the market has gone up or gone down too much. I'm going to explain this in detail as we go on. Another popular use of oscillator is divergences. That means the disconnection between the price and the oscillator. And the another use of oscillator is chartism on oscillators. Now, how to use the powerful, useful tool of divergence? It cannot be seen only on the price alone. It indicates an exhaustive condition. Divergence can only be considered in overbought, oversold conditions. So what are the overbought and the oversold condition? When we say that it's a overbought condition, that means that the stock has moved quite a bit on the upper side and there could be some correction from here on. And when we talk that it's an oversold condition, that means that the stock has been falling for a long time and there can be a bounce back from here. But just a divergence is not enough to take a buy or a sell signal. The first priority should be your price chart. Now, how to take signals based on this? Let's see. से नीचे नहीं जा रहा है. ओके
जस्ट क्लिक द कंट्रोल पैनल.
कंट्रोल पैनल
यस. स्टॉप द क्लिक ऑन वेबकैम.
वेबकैम वेबकैम जस्ट एक मिनट कहां पर है
आप अनाउंस कीजिए ना प्लीज स्टॉप द वेबकैम.
प्लीज स्टॉप द वेबकैम. प्लीज स्टॉप द वेबकैम. क्या कर रहे हैं शेयर नहीं कर रहे हैं.
वेब स्टॉप.
व्हाट इज डूइंग हैज किप
अच्छा करने आप अपना बोलते रहिए. यू डोंट स्टॉप कर रही
अच्छा एक मिनट मुझे नहीं जा रहा था. ओके लेट्स सी हाउ द ऑसिलेटर्स जनरली वर्क. देर आर टू वेरी पॉपुलर काइंड ऑफ There are two very famous kind of oscillators, the RSI and the stochastic. The RSI is between two zones of 0 to 100. The RSI formula is 100 minus 100 divided by 1 plus RS. How the RSI formula is calculated? The RSI formula is calculated as average 100 minus 100 divided by 1 plus RS, where RS is the average of X days up closes and the average of X days down closes. What does that mean? That suppose I calculate a 14 day RSI, that means that in the 14 days, whenever they were closing above the previous day, the average of that is taken in the numerator, and whenever the closing of today has been lower than that of previous day out of the 14 days, in that case, that is, the average of that is considered in the denominator. Now, what are the characteristics of RSI? The RSI trades between the zone of 0 to 100, and in this whole process it shows where the market is leading to. Overbought zones, that is RSI above 70, oversold zone, it is not a purely entry point but rather a profit booking zone. That means a stock has been bought for a long time. There has been a very, very strong momentum in this stock, and it is probably a level where we should not do any extra buying, and if any chance we get, we should look for booking our profits. So RSI above 70 gives us the first sign that probably the stock has been in the bought zone, or it has been with the bulls for a long time. And it's time to book some profits here. But just having a RSI above 70 is not an indication that we will sell our stock. In the price chart, we should get any kind of signal. It could be a candlestick reversal pattern. It could be, we can say that a bad news, economic news. It could be a bad news in the sector, or it could be a price pattern in the price chart, which gives us an indication that probably the stock is going for a correction. So only when the RSI is above 70, and also the price chart is showing us the first signs of reversals combined with RSI above 70, only then we take that we need to actually exit or do some profit booking. Only when the market exits from that high volatility zone, we can initiate an entry point. That means after the RSI has started moving above the 70 zone, it remains there sometimes and the stock might move up. So we keep on our buy trade, but we do not buy anything extra above the RSI above 70. Now when after coming from that RSI zone of 70, this RSI level comes to say around 50 is considered to be a middle point or a support zone for RSI. So if you want to buy that stock again on a correction, you should look for an RSI value of around 50 for entering this stock again. Now, divergences are only valid in the overbought and oversold zone. What is a divergence? It means that the price chart, according to the price chart, the stock is still making new highs and it is on a very, very strong upside momentum. But the RSI has stopped making new highs and it has started making lower highs or some kind of price patterns instead. So that gives you the first indication that the momentum, the inherent momentum of that stock is now reducing. Though it's moving up, the initial momentum which was there with it, the strength, the earlier strength, is now actually reducing. So it's time to look for opportunities. If you get any kind of opportunities in the price chart, for example, in the example which I have given of British pound, the first indication came when the British pound was still making new highs at these zones and making newer highs and in a very, very strong upside momentum. But the RSI, 14-day RSI, is very, very popular. It is inbuilt in most of the softwares. But yes, we can always change the figures. If we want a 7-day RSI, we can have a 9-day RSI. We can have any figure as we want. It depends on our own notions. But the most popular one is a 14-day RSI. So what happens that here sometimes, I'll explain the head and shoulder part just right now, okay? So what happens here that sometimes head and shoulder is a part of basic price patterns. That means just like our normal face we have and two shoulders. The face is higher than the two shoulders and the two shoulders are almost at the same position. Similarly, in the price chart sometimes or even in the RSI, the middle part, the head, is higher and it should be above the 70 zone and the shoulders are lower than the head and both the shoulders are almost of the same price. So say if the RSI head is around 78, then the shoulders are say around 75. Both shoulders should touch around 75 or 74. They are called the two shoulders and the head is higher than the shoulder. So when that head and shoulder forms, it is a sign that we could be topping in the RSI. And once the lower red line is broken on the third shoulder, that means on the third position, that is the first sign that price chart could give some reversals. But for proper reversals, we have to wait for the confirmation from the price chart. The confirmation can be in the form of a candlestick reversal pattern. It could be a trend line breakdown. A trend line, the red line here, which is there in the British pound, that is a trend line in the upper price chart. If that is broken on a closing basis on the lower side, that is the first signal that probably there could be some correction coming in the price chart as well. So it's time to book profits in the long, if you were long in this stock, and if the price is going up but the RSI is going down, that is what we call as negative divergence. Okay, negative divergence means that the price chart is moving in an upper direction but the RSI is moving in a lower direction. So this is called a negative divergence. So what happens in this case is that probably price, there is inherent strength of the stock is reducing and there could be some correction coming in this particular stock. So it's not always that the negative divergence will work, or if there is a negative divergence, always the stock will go down. But we have to look for opportunities. So if you wanted to short this stock or sell this stock or keep a short position, it's time that you actually see in the price chart and look for a reversal signal, maybe a trend line breakdown, maybe a pattern breakdown, maybe a candlestick reversal. Anything could be the first sign. But just because it's a negative divergence is not enough. The price chart should be of the primary importance. The indicators are only meant to be an additional tool or a helping hand. So here, if it's a head and shoulder or whether it's a negative divergence, we need to look at the price chart and find out that what is the probable zone. Now, what is a positive divergence? A positive divergence is when the stock is still falling and there are no new lows being made, and the RSI has started, actually bottomed out it has, and it has started making higher highs. So the, in this FTSE index, what we are seeing is the price chart is still, the price chart is still making new lows, and it is in a zone where it is in a downtrend, but the oscillator RSI has started making higher lows. So this, that means the difference between the price chart and the oscillator, yes, it's a higher high and higher lows. So the price chart, or the price chart of this index, is still making what? Lower lows. New lows are being made. 1, 2, 3 times. But the RSI, after making this low and coming to the oversold zone. Oversold zone is a zone that shows that there has been a lot of selling in this stock, lot of correction, and that's why it's very dangerous here to short again. Rather, if you get a buying opportunity here, you should buy. But just giving a positive divergence, that means the RSI making higher highs. Here the RSI making higher lows, and the is not enough. In the price chart, there should be some confirmation coming. It could be a change in the economic news. It could be that there is some change in the fundamentals of the company. It could be a candlestick reversal, positive reversal pattern, say a morning star or an engulfing pattern. That pattern is there, which gives you a signal that the bulls are now coming in this stock. But RSI only is an additional tool which says that the stock is still making lower lows, but RSI has started making higher lows. So that is an indication that in the coming days, there could be a reversal from these prices. So look for opportunities in the price chart. There could be a good results coming. There could be a good economic news. There could be a change in the fundamentals of the particular country. Any change, or the fundamentals of that particular stock. The change could be any. But price chart is the raw chart. Oscillator are only meant to be used as an additional tool. So RSI giving a positive divergence. This is called positive divergence. And this positivity shows that probably there are going to be an upside moves from here. Look in the price chart. And any opportunity you get for buying, do buy it. So here, in this case, there was a change in momentum from down to up. Okay, so this RSI giving a positive divergence and then leaving the oversold zone and moving up was a first signal that things could change for this index. Now, suppose sometimes it always may not be a downtrend. Sometimes the stock may be in a consolidation or a trading range. What is a consolidation or a trading range? It means that a stock might have given a very sharp upside move, or in this case it's a downside move, and the stock is trading in a range. Trading range means, suppose for last 2 months the stock has been on the upper zone. Whenever it comes to a price of say around 200, there is a selling pressure and it starts falling from that price, and whenever it comes to a price of 150, from there it starts bouncing back. So both side are in the 1-200 zone. There is a very important resistance zone or a supply zone, and around 150 there is a very good support zone or a buying zone. So whenever it comes, the price comes around 150, the buyers become stronger and they do not let the stock fall below the 150 zone. And whenever the stock is going towards the 200 level or a price, the sellers become stronger and they do not let the stock move above 200. So then when the stock for a long time keeps trading between two price. That is called a trading range. So here also the oscillators help. When the stock has been moving in a trading range for a long time and the RSI, after being in a oversold zone when there was a correction and a consolidation, and it starts making actually a higher lows. That is the first sign when you get an idea that RSI giving a positive signal might be a positive signal even for the price chart. So look for buying opportunities in the price chart. Any kind of reversal or positive reversal signal in this case could be a trigger of a change in trend from down to up. So look for those opportunities in the price chart. Now after the RSI, one again we can use RSI for price patterns like head and shoulders, and also for double bottoms, double tops. All those for that RSI are very popular. The overbought and the oversold zone of RSI are popular. The 50 or the middle zone of RSI is also popular. So whenever the stock comes or moves above the 70 zone, it's time that we become a bit cautious. The stock has been bought too much. Do not buy too much of stocks here. And whenever at the overbought zone, you are getting either a negative divergence or some kind of economic bad news, or could be a candlestick reversal pattern coming, at that time it's time to exit or exit long positions. And if you wanted to create some short position, you can. And when the stock has been oversold, that means there has been mass selling, a lot of correction in the stock, it's time to look for buying. But if only RSI is giving a positive divergence, or a price or a double bottom in RSI, or a head in inverse head and shoulder in RSI, any kind of reversal signals in RSI when it has entered the oversold zone can be a very, very powerful signal that probably from here on we can have a bounce back. Again, the middle line of 50 is when a stock is in a very, very strong uptrend. If it is in a very strong uptrend, the momentum is it is making higher highs and higher lows, and people are very bullish of that particular script. So when it has entered a very strong primary uptrend, at that time what happens is whenever the stock comes near the 50 level of RSI, that 50 level of RSI a lot of time has a tendency of acting as a support for a stock which is in a very bad trend or a downtrend, and it has tested the oversold zone. In that case, whenever it comes around a level of 50, at that time, that 50 level in RSI daily chart can be an important resistance point from where the selling could again start in the stock. So RSI, when used in conjunction with price chart, can be a very, very useful leading indicator. So it can give us an idea about where we are going, where we are heading, and also it can give us an idea that probably we can have a change in trend with the help of RSI. And the change in trend can be recognized before the price chart using an RSI.